Hi everyone. Welcome to another Getting Started with Canvas screencast. This time I'm going to review Canvas's attendance tool, Roll Call. Roll Call is designed to help instructors keep track of attendance and student participation. By default, the tool is set up so that students are awarded points for attendance, and if they have good attendance, then they keep those points throughout the term. If they miss class or if they're late, then they lose those points as they go. To use Roll Call, the first step is to enable the tool. Go to Settings, and then to Navigation. Now add the Attendance tool by dragging the menu item up and dropping it into your course navigation. Remember to save this change. Now the Attendance tool is active in the course menu. Note that your students won't see the Attendance tool. What they will see is attendance in their gradebook listed as one of their assignments. At this time, Roll Call doesn't give us the ability to create the necessary attendance assignment unless we use the tool and take attendance. If you look at the Roll Call settings in the tool, for example, you won't see any way to configure or create an assignment. While this might change in the future, for now, the only way to generate the attendance assignment you need is to take attendance at least once. Let me demonstrate. If you look at assignments before using the tool to take attendance, you'll see that adding the tool by itself doesn't actually generate the attendance assignment. However, if I go to the tool and take attendance one time, when I go back to assignments, I can see that taking attendance has also generated an assignment called Roll Call Attendance, which is what I need. You can see here and in the gradebook that the default value of the attendance assignment is set to 100. You'll also see that when the tool generated the assignment, it dropped it into the first assignment group. As a best practice, I recommend that you move the attendance assignment into its own assignment group. I'll create a new group and call it attendance, and then I'll move the assignment into that group. Now, if you think that 100 points is too much for attendance, you can change that. Let's open and edit the assignment. I'll change the point value to 20. And I want the point value and the display of points to be consistent, so I'll choose to display the grade as points. Know that in your attendance assignment, while it's okay to change the point value and the way that the grade is displayed, changing the name of the assignment will break the tool. Without the name just as it is here, Canvas won't be able to track the attendance in the gradebook. So be sure to leave the name, even if you make other changes to the points. Let's take a look at what's happening in the gradebook. You'll see now that the value is set to 20 points, but the students were given 100 points, which was the default value, when I created the attendance assignment by taking attendance. So, this looks pretty bad, because instead of students getting the 20 points that I wanted them to have, these three students have 100 points, which means that they have 5 times too many points. While this looks bad right now, the next time you take attendance, these numbers are going to adjust according to the new value that you just set. Let me demonstrate. I'll go back to the attendance tool, undo the attendance that I took earlier, and then take attendance again. Now let's go back to the gradebook and take a look. Now you can see that the attendance is correct. Each student present has the full 20 points allotted for attendance. Okay, now that everything's set up correctly and working the way that I want it to work, using the attendance tool to take attendance is going to be very straightforward. Let me show you the features of the tool. I can mark everyone present at one time, and I can also easily toggle each individual present, absent, or late. I can unmark everyone at one time. You can see here that I have multiple sections in this course, and my students are automatically separated into separate sections on each tab. Also, note the calendar. I can move from day to day, and I can also select a day in the past if I want to review the student's history. I can look at all of the attendance information related to any one student by selecting More next to the student's name. The information here includes the number of days the student was present, total number of days late, total number of days absent. And I can use Roll Call to keep track of student participation. I do this by using the tool's badging feature. The badging feature allows me to track the quality of students' participation. The default badges are absent for a religious holiday, participation, present with a thumbs up, an excused tardy, an unexcused tardy, and a university excused absence. For each day, I can give a student any of these badges by toggling the badge on. I can also create custom badges. Let's say that I'm doing an in-class group activity and I want to note student initiative and leadership. I do this by adding a badge. I'll call this badge Leadership. I'll add an icon to the badge. I'll associate student leadership with a megaphone. And I can give the badge a color. I'll give it green for initiative. Now when I save this badge, I'll be able to award it to any student in this class for the entire term. If I decide that this badge isn't exactly what I wanted, I'll go into Manage Badge, and from here I can edit the badge, or I can delete it. Know that your students won't see these badges. These badges are here to help you monitor and keep track of the quality of student participation as you go. The attendance tool stores and keeps track of all of the student information in three different areas. In the list area, where students are listed with their records attached. In the more visual class area that includes a seating chart, you'll see here that all of the same information is available for each student. And finally, the tool saves the student attendance information in a report that you can download. As we wrap up this screencast, I want to offer you a strategy that you might want to use if you decide that you do want to use Roll Call to keep track of attendance and participation, but that you don't want to associate any points with attendance. The easiest way to do this is to set weights for each of your assignment groups. Let me demonstrate. I'll go back to Assignments. Because I have all of my assignments in groups, I can now set weights for each of the groups. If I don't want a grade associated with attendance, then all I have to do is set the attendance group weight to 0%. If you choose to do this, you can leave the default attendance settings as they are and use the tool to track attendance and participation so that you have a record. But if you set the weight of the group to 0, then attendance won't affect the students' grades at all. That's all for this screencast. If you have any more questions about Canvas, be sure to visit CSU's Canvas Help site or Instructure's Canvas Help Center.